فؤادك الأيام فتى.
Now brothers, I'm going to ask you the fifth point inshallah ta'ala, which is, does the da'wah, does it differ from time to time and place to place? The da'wah change? Does the da'wah change? And it's flexible that we can change it whenever situation we're in. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger said, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. Anybody who introduces in our affairs that which is not from it, it's rejected from him. Imam Muslim rahimahullah, he narrated that. Imam Malik ibn Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said a statement. This statement of his deserves to be written of ink of gold. Ink of gold. And every da'i who's calling to the path of Allah, and every person who is embarking on the path of seeking knowledge, should always remember that Imam Malik rahimahullah, he said, لَنْ يُصْلِحَ آخِرَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ إِلَّا مَا أَصْلَحَ أَوَّلَهَا. That this ummah, the later part of the ummah, will not find prosperity and good except that which the first generation found prosperity and good in. The prosperity and the good that we're looking for, the success that we're trying to find, we won't find it except in that which the first early generations found it in. And the Sahabas, the way they found it in, is the way we're only going to find it. Al-Shaykh Al-Allama Abdul Aziz ibn Baz rahmatullahi alayhi mu'alliqan, he commented on the statement of Malik ibn Anas, and this is what he said. Pay attention. A scholar speaking and expanding and explaining this point. He said, Man arada, anyone who wants صلاح المجتمع الإسلامي, anyone who wants to change and perfect the situation of the Muslim community, أو إصلاح المجتمعات الأخرى, or he wants to change the other societies, he wants to change the Muslim society, or he wants to change the other societies, bring them perfection and good, if he wants to do that, في هذه الدنيا, in this world, بغير الطرق والوسائل والعوامل التي صلح بها الأولون, without the path and the means and the factors that perfected the first generation, فَغَدْ غَلَطَ, that person has done a mistake. وَقَالَ غَيْرَ الْحَقِّ, and he said other than the truth. فَالدَّعْوَةُ دَعْوَى لَا تَتَغَيَّرُ بِتَغَيُّرُ الْأَحْوَالِ, the da'wah does not change because of the changing of situations. Imam Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, one more time. مَنْ أَرَادَ صَلَاحَ الْمُجْتَمَعِ الْإِسْلَامِي, anybody who wants to change the Muslim society, or صلاح المجتمعات الأخرى, or he wants to change the other societies in this world, في هذه الدنيا, without what? بغير الطرق, without the path, والوسائل والعوامل التي صلح بها الأولون, he wants to do in a path and a means and factors that the first generation did not. فقد غلط, he done a mistake and he's wrong. وقال غير الحق, and he has said other than the truth. فالدعوة أو الدعوة لا تتغير, it doesn't change بتغير الأحوال, it doesn't change because of the situation changing. الله أكبر. The next 6 points, brothers, is that we all have to realize is, did Allah place on our shoulders the results? Are we responsible for the results of our da'wah? كلا والله لا, that's not our job. The result is not our job. We are just those who have to go out and convey. We just have to convey. A hadith which is of what? Which is of the condition of Imam al-Bukhari. It's of the condition of Imam al-Bukhari. على شرط البخاري. As Shu'ayb al-Arnaut said, rahimahullah, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, عُرِضَتْ عَلَيَّ الْأُمَمْ, the nations have been presented to me. فَرَأَيْتُ النَّبِيَّ, I saw a prophet. وَمَعَهُ الرُّهَيْطُ والنبي ومعه الرجل والرجلان والنبي وليس معه أحد. And the hadith narrated also by Imam Abdullah ibn Abbas, narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, from the hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas, that he said, I saw, or the Prophet said, it was presented to me the nations, and I saw a prophet with him is a ruhayt. Ruhayt is a from 3 to 9, a small amount of people. And I saw a prophet with him was what? معه الرجل, a man or two. And I saw a prophet, no one was with him. What does that show you? Did that prophet not convey his job? Did he not call the people to the religion of Allah? Has he not done what was upon him? Na'am, he done it. That prophet conveyed the job. He did what he was told to do, alayhi musallam. Ma'adhalika, even then, only one person is with him. Another one has no one with him. And nowadays, if you look at the Ahzab, these sects and these groups, all they are concerned about is numbers. Whatever can enlarge in the group, in the circle, whatever, no problem. We have to grow. We're going, we're becoming less. And that's why are they concerned to even water down the religion? It's a sensitive topic. If you talk to the people, run away. This is tariqa Yahudiya. It's the tariqa of the Jews. It's not tariqa Islamiyya. The Jews are the ones who cared more about what? To come together. Allah said about them, تَحْسَبُهُمْ جَمِيعًا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. They're concerned to come together. When you look at them, you think they're together. Because that's all they worry about. Let's just be together. Let's agree to disagree. نَتَعَوَّنُ فِي مَتَّفَقْنَا عَلَيْهِ. Let's help one another on what we agree upon. وَيَعْذُرُ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا. And we what? And we excuse each other on what we differ on. Let's help each other on what we agree. And whatever we differ on, we excuse one another. طَرِيقَ يَهُودِيَّ خَبِيثًا. It's a methodology set by the Jews. So you see a Shi'i and a person of the Sunnah sitting together, shaking hands, accepting one another. Why? Because of that qa'idah, that principle that was set. It's a mushkila. It's a problem. And that qa'idah, brothers, when I said it's a Yahudiya, لا شك ولا ريب, it can have a good in it, like with its dawabid and with its principles put in place. But the way it's used today, it is to dismantle the Sharia from its totality and lift it from its roots. Na'am. It is to lift it from its roots. Now if you look at these ahzab, these sects, these groups, these jama'at, whether it's Hizb al-Tahrir, Ikhwan al-Muslimin, Jama'at al-Tabligh, all of these groups, when if you look at them, which is the seventh point, all of them, they went against the unity we were ordered to come with. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala ordered us to unify, but upon the haqq, unity upon the haqq. They claim that they bring the ummah together, but they broke the ummah into pieces. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ إِنَّمَا أَمُرْهُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Those people, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ, those who broke their religion into pieces and groups, وَكَانُوا شِيعًا, and they became sects and groups. Allah said, لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ. Muhammad, you have nothing to do with them. See how Allah freed the messenger from those people. And Imam al-Qurtubi, what did he say? أي فِرَقًا وَأَحْزَابًا. Underline that word. Who become what? They become groups and hizb. Look at the name, they're called Hizb al-Tahrir. The hizb, you can see. And Imam al-Qurtubi in his tafsir, in the ayah, he said, فِرَقًا وَأَحْزَابًا. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also said, مُنِيبِينَ إِلَيْهِ وَاتَّقُوهُ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. Surah Al-Rum, ayah 32. What did they do? مُنِيبِينَ إِلَيْهِ, they turned back to their Lord, Allah. وَاتَّقُوهُ, and they fear him. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and they established the prayer. And then Allah said to them, وَلَا تَكُونُوا, and do not be from the pagans and the polytheists. Which ones? مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ, those who broke their religions into pieces and became sects, firaq and ahzab, sects and groups. Don't be like them. وَكَانُوا شِعَ كُلُّ حِزْبٍ, every sect is happy with what he has. Look what you hear today. This group will say, okay, it's bad for the reputation of our group. The wala and the bara is based on the group. They don't care about you. Anything that will reflect evil on the hizb and the group is the concern. Where is the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam where he said, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ جَسَدٍ وَاحِدٍ. Allah said also in the ayah, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. Allah made us an ummah together, united, one. They broke the ummah into groups and said, you're this, you're there, you're that. Listen to this hadith, it's very powerful, this hadith. Imam Ahmad narrated in in his Ilal wa Ma'rifatul Rijal and Hassan al-Basri, that Hassan al-Basri said, Shahadtu yawma taramu bil hasa fi amri Uthman, the day when Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in which he was kept in his house, Yawmud Dar, and Uthman was being killed radiallahu by the Khawarij, the Khubatha. And the people became sects and they became ahzab and groups. Our mother Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, she came out and she said to the people a statement. She said, Inna nabiyyakum, your messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, qad bari'a mimman farraqa deenahu wahtazab. Your Prophet Muhammad, he is free from anybody who breaks his religion and makes cults and sects. Mimman farraqa deenahu wahtazab. The Prophet free from it, alayhi salatu wasalam. Abdullah ibn Imam Ahmad, he said, here Umm Salama, that woman who spoke that day was Umm Salama. Look what she brought together. She said, فَرَّقَ دِينَهُ وَاحْتَزَبْ. Hizb, these Hizbiyin that are out there, they're Ahlul Furqa, and Ikhtilaf. They distinguish the Ummah into groups. This is called Hizb al-Tahrir, this is called Ikhwan al-Muslimin, this is called Jama'at al-Tabligh, and all of them, they have their leaders, and they have their commands that come to them, and they have bay'ah, pledge of allegiance they give to the leader. Na'am, they give bay'ah. And the bay'ah's with the leader. Huh? And they adhere and they submit to him. As-sam'u wa ta'a lil amir. And you have to listen to the manager. You have to bring him back what you have to do. The haq will be dismantled because of the maslaha of the jama'ah. Are the ulama consulted? Abadan. The ulama are what? They are ulama al-sultan. A lot of them. The ulama are what? Ulama don't know the waqi'. Don't tell them the matters. Don't bring no students of knowledge next to us. Why? Because they don't know the waqi'ah that we're dealing with. So what do you want to do? Let's do what we see right. Be jahlin, ignorance. And what has it brought? Fitnatun wa fasadun arid. And the ulama not consulted. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the eighth point, which is what? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has given us names already. We don't need no other name. In Surah Al-Hajj, Ayah 78, Allah said, Huwa sammakum muslimina. Allah has named you Muslims. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Shaykh Al-Albani brought this in his Sahih Al-Jami', that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Walakin tasammaw bismillahi alladhi sammakum ibadallahi al-muslimina al-mu'minina. Call yourselves, that the Messenger said, call yourselves in the names in which Allah has named you. Ibadallah. Allah has called you Ibadallah. Al-Muslimina. Allah said Muslims. Al-Mu'minina. Allah said Mu'minin. Imam Malik, as Ibn Abdul Barr narrated in his book Al-Intiqa, Ibn Abdul Barr, he was asked, a man came up to him, to Imam Malik, rahimahullah, and he said, Ya Aba Abdullah, O Imam Malik, As'aluka an mas'alatin aj'aluka hujjatan fima bayni wa bayna Allahi Azza wa Jalla. I ask you a question in which I make it a proof between me and Allah the day of judgment. Proof for me, between me and Allah. Imam Malik said, Ma sha Allah, whatever Allah wills, la quwwata illa bi. There is no strength except Him. Sal, ask. And the man said, Man ahlus sunnah? Huwa ahlus sunnah? Imam Malik ibn Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Imam Dar al-Hijra, he gives the answer. He said, Ahlus sunnati. Ahlus sunnah are what? Alladhina laysa lahum laqabun. They have no nickname. Yu'rafuna bihi, in which they're known for. La jahmiyun. They are not jahmi. They don't have a name called jahmiya. Wala qadariyun. They don't have a name called qadariya. Wala rafidiyun. And they don't have a name called rafidiyah. That's not their name. Those are all names which are what? Lately introduced. Hizb al-Tahrir introduced. Ikhwan al-Muslimin introduced. What do you call it? Tabligh, Jama'at al-Tabligh. All of those are the name by itself. If you look at it, it is name which is muhdath. The name is a bid'ah aslan. Then what would you await from the qawa'id and the masadir and the evidences in which they are built on? Maymun ibn Mahran, as Imam ibn Battah, he narrated in his book, Al-Ibanatu al-Sughra, Maymun ibn Mahran said, Iyakum, be careful, wa kullu ismin yusamma bighayri al-Islam, be aware of every name that is called other than Islam. A name, a person calls themselves other than the name of Islam. Malik ibn Maghul رضي الله تعالى عنه ابن بطة in his book Al-Ibana, he said إِذَا تَسَمَّ الرَّجُلُ if a person calls himself بِغَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ other than the name of Islam وَالسُّنَّةِ أهل السنة فَأَلْحِقُ بِأَيِّ دِينِ شِئْتَ add, make him reach him with any religion you wish. إمام إمام الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية in his مجموعة الفتاوى he said والواجب على المسلم إذا سئل عن ذلك أن يقول if a person is asked for who is he for him to reply and say لا أنا شكيلي I am not شكيلي ولا قرفندي there were groups بل rather he should say أنا مسلم متبع لكتاب الله I am a Muslim who follows the book of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم فلا نعدل عن الأسماء we will not turn away from the names التي سمان الله بها the names which Allah has given us إلى أسماء to names أحدثها قوم a people who have introduced later سموها هم they call these names وآباؤهم and their forefathers ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان Allah has not brought any proof for these names. There's no proof for it. The ninth point, inshallah ta'ala. Having a large number of followers, is that an indication that your manhaj is sahih? If you have a lot of people who are following you and there are a large number of people, does that indicate that you are upon the manhaj which is sahih? Qala ta'ala, Allah says, no it doesn't. No it doesn't. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, In Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 116, وَإِنْ تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّوكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَإِنْ هُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُصُونَ Allah says, if you obey the majority of the people on the face of this earth, they will misguide you from the straight path. They are not following except their whims and their desires and speculation and assumption. So Allah says, if you obey the majority of the people on the face of this earth, They will misguide you. The majority will misguide you. وقال تعالى Allah also said وما أكثر الناس ولو حرصت بمؤمنين The majority of the people are not even if you are not even believers and they are not people of guidance even if you strive for it. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى He said in Surah Al-Ma'idah Ayah 100 قل لا يستوي الخبيث والطيب The good and the evil are not equal. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ Even if it mind-boggles you, amazes you, how large the evil is. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِيَ اللَّهِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ Those of you who have intellect, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, as Abu Qasim, Hibatullah ila al-Lakai'i narrated in his book, شرح أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Al-jama'a, the jama'a is who? Ma wafaq al-haqq, anyone who is in agreement to the haqq. Walau kunta wahdak, even if you're alone. Fudayl ibn Iyad, as Imam al-Shatibi narrated in his kitab, Al-I'tisam. And also, Al-Imam al-Nawawi narrated in his majmu', which is a sharah of Al-Muhadhab li Abi Ishaq al-Shirazi. That Fudayl ibn Iyad said, عَلَيْكَ بِالطَّرِيقِ الْهُدَى وَإِنْ قَلَّ السَّالِكُونَ Upon you is the path of guidance, even if those who are treading on it are little in number. وَاجْتَنِبْ طَرِيقَ الرَّدَى وَإِنْ كَثُرَ الْهَالِكُونَ Stay away from the path of destruction, even if the ones who are treading on it is a lot. That goes against the qa'ida of the people of Ahzab. They are concerned about number. They are concerned about the tickets that are sold. They are concerned about how much people they've brought in. That's all their concern is. Now, brothers, I want to ask you, what is the position of the ulama? The ulama are who? Al-ulama al-rabbaniyun. The ulama al-rabbaniyin, the scholars who are elite and grounded upon the kitab and sunnah, on the understanding of the pious predecessors. What was their position regarding the jama'at and the ahzab that we have today? These groups and these sects. Who broken the ummah into pieces, who have misguided the ummah, what is the position of the ulama regarding them? The scholars, brothers and sisters, are upon agreement that they are misguided. And I'm going to read some of the great scholars of this time. I'm going to read you the speech of a Shaykh, Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, regarding them. Ibn Uthaymeen, his book, كتاب الصحوة الإسلامية والضوابط والتوجيهات ابن عثيمين said the following ليس في الكتاب there is not in the book of Allah ولا في السنة, and it is not in the sunnah. ما يبيح, that which permits, تعدد الجماعات والأحزاب, that which permits to make a lot of groups and sects. My name is called this, we make a lot of groups and we break off. And each one is claiming that we're working towards da'wah. These people, they're doing this, don't worry, that's what they're focusing on. We're focusing on this, and this branch, they focus on that, and that branch. Ibn Uthaymeen said, لَيْسَ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَلَا فِي السُّنَّةِ مَا يُبِيحُ تَعَدُّدِ الْجَمَاعَاتِ وَالْأَحْزَابِ. There's nothing in the book that permits that. بَلْ رَاذَ إِنَّ فِي الْكِتَابِ, rather what is in the book of Allah, وَالسُّنَّةِ, and that which is in the sunnah is, ذَمَّ لِذَلِكَ, that it rebukes that and it speaks against it. قَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah said, فَتَقَطَّعُوا أَمَرَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ زُبُرًا كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. They broke their affairs into pieces amongst themselves, and then Allah said, all of the groups and the sects and the hazab, what they have is what pleases them. Surah Al-Mu'minun, ayah 53. Ibn Uthaymeen goes on to say, وَلَا شَكَّ, without a doubt, أَنَّ تَعَدُّدَ هَذِي الْأَحْزَابِ, that breaking these groups, these large number of groups that are out there, يُنَافِي مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ, it opposes and goes against that which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has ordered. بَلْ رَاذَ مَا حَثَّ عَلَيْهِ فِي قَوْلِهِ, rather it goes against that which Allah and His Messenger have urged, especially in the verse of Allah, إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ, this is your ummah, أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا, one ummah, not groups, but one ummah, وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُونَ, and I am your Lord, worship me. 92. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, rahimahullah. Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, he said in his fatawa, when he was to a man by the name of Ukash ibn Abd al-Mannan, Sheikh al-Albani said, rahimahullah, لا يخفى على كل مسلم عارف بالكتاب والسنة وما كان عليه سلفنا الصالح رضي الله عنهم أن التحزب والتكتل في جماعات مختلفة المناهج والأساليب ليس من الإسلام في شيء, بل ذلك مما نهى عنه ربنا عز وجل في أكثر من آية في القرآن الكريم. محمد المحدث, محمد ناصر الدين الباني رحمه الله, in his fatwa he said, لا يخفى, it is not hidden, على كل مسلم, every Muslim who عارف بالكتاب والسنة, who knows the book of Allah and the Sunnah, وما كان عليه سلفنا الصالح, and knows that which our pious predecessors were upon, أن التحزب والتكتل, secting, partisanism, في جماعات مختلفة, in different groups, المناهج, different methodologies they have, والأساليب, and different ways, ليس من الإسلام, it is not from Islam whatsoever. بل rather, ذلك مما نهى عنه, rather that is what Allah has prohibited, ربنا, our Lord, عز وجل, higher and above he is, في أكثر من آية في القرآن, in more than one places in the Quran. الشيخ دكتور, شيخ صالح الفوزان, عضو هيئة كبار العلماء, he gave a fatwa, شيخ صالح الفوزان, he said the following, he said, التفرق ليس من الدين, breaking apart and becoming group, it's not from the religion, لأن الدين أمرنا بالاجتماع, because the religion has ordered us to unite, وأن نكون جماعة, and that we become one جماعة, وأمة واحدة, and we become one nation, على عقيدة التوحيد, but we unite upon the توحيد, وعلى متابعة الرسول, and we unite upon what? Following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the Shaykh recited the ayah in Surah Ali Imran, ayah 103. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا, hold on to the rope of Allah and do not become groups. If you want to see that, go to the book مرجعيات في فقه الواقع على ضوء الكتاب والسنة. Also, الشيخ بكر بن عبد الله أبو زيد رحمه الله, who was عضو هيئة كبار العلماء, in his book خصائص الجزئية العربية وحكم الانتماء إلى الفرق والجماعات الإسلامية, he said رحمه الله, فواجب والله تنظيف هذه الجزيرة من تلكم المناهج الفكرية المبتدعة والأهواء الضالة, وأن تبقى عنوان نصرة للكتاب والسنة والسير على هدي سلف الأمة جربا للبدع والأهواء المضلة. He said, it is obligatory to cleanse from this Arabian Peninsula, to cleanse from these methodologies and these views which are bid'ah innovation, and these misguided ideologies, and that the sign of victory should be based on the Kitab and the Sunnah and the path of the guided pious predecessors, and harban, to fight lil bid'a'i, innovation, wal ahwa' al mudilla, and to fight with innovation and whims and desires that misguide. Ikhwani, I'm going to mention some of the things that these groups have as problems. The first problem that it has, all these groups, if we looked at them, is, and this, brothers, is only some. The problem that they have, Ikhwani, is Aqdul wala'i wal bara. They base love and hate on the group. They love one another based on the group. Anyone who's following the group, they love them. Any person who differs with them, sees something indifferent towards them, there is hate and bara, and they free themselves. And wala wal bara is not based on a hizb. Al-wala wal bara is based on what? It is based upon iman. And it's based on the sunnah. Na'am. The second thing, Ikhwani, is intisharul bid'a wal ahwa'i wal jahl. Innovation, whims and desires and ignorance are prevalent in them. Ignorant of the methodology of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the manhaj al-nabawi, the prophetic methodology in how to call the people to the religion. Innovation is prevalent in them. Like Hizb al-Tahrir, who believe Khabar al-Ahad fi Masail al-Aqaid, it is not taken. Or Khabar al-Ahad is not taken aslan. Is batil, is aqaid al-Mu'tazila. They try to say it can't be taken in aqaid only. لكن هذا فكر معتزلين خبيث. How are you going to establish Islamic government when you believe this? Na'am. And if you look at their leader in which they ascribe back to, he's a Naqshbandi Sufi. He's a Naqshbandi, a turuq min turuq al-Sufiyya, he ascribes back to. If you look at Ikhwan al-Muslimin, Hassan al-Banna and the rest of them, Hassan al-Banna was a Sufi. The Sufiyya praise him. They love him. Na'am. So there you see bid'ah and innovation and jahl prevalent in them. ولذلك حسن البنا والخميني اللعين عامله الله بما يستحق. May Allah give him what he deserves. والخميني, he done his ثورة, his protest, he demonstrated, and he put down the Safawi that were before the so-called Ayatollahs, before the so-called leadership that they put in place right now. Hassan al-Banna, he went to Iran and he greeted them to give them glad tidings of their successful and how they succeeded in what? In removing the previous dictatorship, as they call it, and their success. And then this is what their message was. Khomeini alayhi min Allahi ma yastahiq, may Allah give him what he deserves. He looked at Hassan al-Banna and he said to him, whatever I have done, do it elsewhere. Carry on in all of the Arab world. Until we saw the fitna of what? Arab Spring. Now, the third problem that they have, Ikhwani, is they've taken the Muslim strength away from them. The Ummah's strength was in what? Our strength lied in unity. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said to us, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا, do not dispute one another, فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَتَبَرِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Don't distinguish, don't divide, don't dispute one another. And what will happen? فَتَفْشَلُوا, you will lose. وَتَتَبَرِيحُكُمْ, and your power and your strength will go. وَاصْبِرُوا, be patient. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. So they deceived us. They broke our strength. They turned us into different groups. Fulani is from this group. He doesn't talk to the other one, he's from the other group. And the other one from the other one, they don't talk to one another. Broke the ummah into what? Groups and ahzab and sects. Na'am. And if you look at that ayah, the book Al-Furusiyatul Muhammadiyya by Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim, the last part when he talks about Qutbul Raha, Qutbatul Nasr, the dome of victory. He speaks about this ayah, that one of them is that the ummah don't divide. Ikhwani, the things regarding them is excessive in number. The lack of knowledge of da'wah and what to call to. The first thing that they approach is politics and siyasat. And the first person, Ikhwani, this ideology of bringing da'wah and forcing da'wah and politics. Politics is what? It's filthy politics I'm talking about, that the world now works on, to bring the da'wah into it and to say that the da'wah can't move unless unless politics is a part of it. And the du'at and the students of knowledge have to busy themselves with politics by making sure that they participate in parliamental elections and they have a seat in the what? They have a seat and they... all of that, the first person was to say that was Jamaluddin al-Afghani. Then Muhammad Abdul carried on from that. And then it became a methodology that many people then took, thinking that if we don't elect and if we don't, there's no way forward. نسأل الله الثبات على الحق والعزيمة على الرشد. Where is the methodology of the messenger? They don't call to Tawheed. All day they're fighting with politics and siyasat and governments. Well, where is where the Prophet started it from it? Our Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin Albani used to say, قِمْ دَوْلَةَ الْإِسْلَامِ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ تُقَمْ عَلَى أَرْضِكُمْ. Establish an Islamic government in your own household, in your hearts, on your land, on yourselves, and Allah will establish it on your lands for you. That same man who is the leader of a hizb and a group, his wife is aariya. He doesn't pray the salah in the jama'ah. He doesn't have any Islamic ethics. And he's telling you he's out there to what? To call to the bringing back of the ummah's honor. So wallahi, this issue of a tahazzub wa tafarruq, ikhwani, it is a fitnah, mallahu bihi alim. It's a balaya. It's a problem, only Allah knows it. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the harm that he's caused the ummah as a whole. Na'am. We're going to take the statement of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen in this issue, inshaAllah ta'ala.